What is up, everybody? Thank you for visiting my channel. And today is September 17th, and today is also Friday, which means that my puts are expiring today. I have two puts expiring today. Very excited about that. You can see here, I sold these puts previously for about $4,500 for this one and $3,000 for this one. And this morning, I bought them back for $3 each. So I made about $7,500 for these two puts. And these puts were expiring today, and it was $700 to $670. The stock price for Tesla today is $750, so they're definitely out of the money. So it's great. So you can see here's a put that I sold last week that I recorded, and currently it's up about $500. I sold it for about $2,300, and now it's worth negative $1,900. And the one I did last month that's expiring next week, I'm currently almost in the money for all of it, about 80% of the way there, but the 685, I'm pretty sure that's gonna, I'm for sure gonna have this $400 by next week. So, so I think people are saying, like, isn't it risky to sell puts because, you can lose a lot of money? And I feel like if you have conviction in the stock, it's not risky because, if worst comes to worst, you just buy the stock for that price and, you get stuck with the stock, which is what I wanted anyways. So I would say it's actually very not risky. I would say it's less risky than selling calls, because selling calls is like you either hit that number or you don't. If you don't hit it, you lose all your money. Whereas here is like, I got some leeway. If I don't want to buy the stock, I can always pay for the premium. So it's not risky to me at all. And my strategy, like I said before, was to sell one put each week. I have two expiring today for some reason. I was just messing around. The reason this is so much money, like more than 2,000, is because I sold this for 7 weeks out. I sold this on August 1st or so. So there was more time. So there's like greater risk. That's why it's more money. So like, I could have gotten 1¾ puts in this time, but I ended up getting, double the money. So I don't know. So like, I'm just trying to do 1 week out. So yeah, so currently in the money for both of these, or out of the money for both of these, however you say it. And basically I made $7,500. So then I bought those back for $3 each. And then I sold two more puts, which I did this morning. I just took screenshots just now. So when I sold the put, you can see these are the two puts I sold. I did a 7:30 for both 4 weeks from today, which is going to be October 15th. And I did a 5 weeks from today, which is October 22nd. And the reason I did that is just so I have things expiring every week. I find it very exciting to be like, hey, Friday, the put's expiring. I made money. So right now, these are four puts I have. Obviously, I'm missing one for October 1st for some reason. So, maybe when this one expires, I'll probably do one for 4 weeks out. I'll be missing a month, which I guess I'll have to live with. But anyways, so these two puts I sold, you can see I'm making about, I don't have that number here, but essentially it's going to be about $2,800 to $2,700 plus the 100, about $2,400. So about $5,200 for these two puts I'm selling if they expire in the money, which I'm sure they will. If not, then I'll lose some money. But my break-even price is about $700, $705 for each of those. So if I had to buy it at $700, then, so be it. I don't care. I actually kind of want to get forced to buy shares just because, like, if the price keeps rising, I keep selling puts, I'll make money. However, I won't have the shares, right? So if it rises really fast, then I'll lose out on it. Another question someone asked me was, like, oh, wouldn't you have made more money just buying the stocks? And I don't think that's true, because if you think about it, in this last, if this put right here expires on, if this put right here, the $2,000 one expires in the money, which it probably will, because it's already 685, right? So this morning I was at 2,000, now it's like 2,100. So imagine if this one expires, then I would have had it made in 3 months, I would have made about $19,000. And if you take a look at Tesla stock price, let's say 3 months ago, the stock price was, let's see, in about July-ish is when I started. Let's say July 1st is at 680. No, that's June. So July 1st, it was at, okay, let's just say 670, right? 670. So right now it's 750. So if I had bought shares, I would have made 750 minus 670. I would have made about $80 a share. If I made $19,000, then I would have to have bought 240 shares to make 19 grand. And that would have cost me 670. I would have to spend $159,000 to make that money, which, I spent $0 and I made that money. So, I mean, I would say selling puts is definitely much more financially, I don't know, better, at least for now. Especially because, like, if you think about this, like, look at this. Like, someone's paying me, like, $4,000. Someone's paying me $4,000 to sell, to, like, and they only make money if the price goes, like the price goes down, like, you know, all the way down to, like, 660 or something like that because of the price. So it's like someone's paying me money to, like, buy these shares at a very low price. It's like the bet on the other side, it seems really dumb to me. Okay, another thing that I wanted to talk about briefly is, like, there's, like, so much FUD, right? And it's all headlines. So, like, for example, one thing I noticed in the news today, and there's a ton of examples on this, you can look it up, but just one thing I noticed is, like everyone's talking about how Kathy Wood, like, dumps so much stock, right? Oh, she dumped, like, 80,000 shares or, you know, $60 million of these shares. And it's like, look at these headlines, right? So, oh my God, it's like so much money. But like, how many shares does ARK have? I just Googled it. It's like, they have like 3 million shares. So like, they essentially dumped 2% of their portfolio, right? Like their portfolio has like over 10% weight. I don't know how up to date these numbers are, but like just kind of from perspective, they dumped 2%, right? Now there's all this FUD saying Tesla is like, people are like, their number one supporter is selling all these shares. So it's like, it's just really stupid. You have to look past the headlines. Anyways, cool. Hope this helps, and talk to you guys in the next one.